afternoon, ladies and gents, or a good evening. We're here to pick up a Freightliner box truck. So they left this truck last night when it broke down, left it in this parking lot, and they gave us a call today to pick it up. We're gonna go ahead and see what's going on with it. I don't know whose van that is, but we'll see what we can do. Probably wiggle this one around. They didn't tell me exactly what's going on with it. I believe my manager said that it was just an engine overheat, so we could probably move it around. See right now what this one has right here. Nope, that's not good. It won't do anything. All right, so gonna hook it up. Let's pull this pin out. Probably move a little bit off this van right here. But yeah, this one, they called it in the morning. I showed up, and this parking lot was really, really packed. There was a car literally parked right here in this parking spot, which I couldn't do anything. And then right behind this truck, there's a small space. Of course, another car parked out there, leaving me no room to work. So yeah, I had to come back So here we are now. The other side, a little bit more this way, right there. That looks better. All right, go ahead and get my tools for the dry line, and also my airline. Which that one right there, that's the only one I see. Check one more time. I think this is the only air tank. Yeah. Another one right there, but if anything, I'll just end up on there. Man, I got it. I was just gonna keep the brakes. Thank you.
much bigger than that.
Bigger one and see if it works with this one.
The tiny one.
No, it worked.
That's always good. I don't have the
one for the back.
I think it's welded in there. this test right here. Get that one out. There's no way to nothing up there.
It's awesome.
I took the air out of her
secondary, so let's go check out the primary. Hopefully we can get that going. Not doing. I'm not taking the air out of here. Oh, so I'm gonna have no brakes. Cool. My brakes are gonna be. Goodness, my eyes are killing me. Allergies are kicking in right now. Go ahead and put the light bar. One up right there. The other one right here. And bring it down. Nice and flashy. Actually, yeah, that's fine. Mm-hmm. go to the next one. Get it as tight as I can. There you go. Now, so we're gonna go ahead and disconnect the drive line.
Let's see, where can I get it at?
So, the reason why I brought these wrenches right here is to basically to get them loose. You don't want to use an impact gun straight up, because you'll find out the hard way. Well, I found out the hard way when I went to do it. It gives it so much power. Well, that gun has so much power that if you don't break those, what do you call this, those bolts, if you don't break them loose, you can snap them. So make sure you always use that. Always make sure you break them loose first. It's gonna swing that way. So once I drop, there you go. So now I can get him. So yeah, don't be like me. Don't find out the hard way. Secure. This extra, just gonna tie it down around here. It doesn't go anywhere. The flashlight. Almost done. Can I go ahead and put some safety chains on? Then get out of here.
see.
Get my creeper and then we're good to go. Go ahead and take a picture. Give it a little bit more chain, both ends. That way we can make those corners pretty good. All right, guys. So I will see you all at the drop. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. So last night I went to pick up this box truck, and we were supposed to bring it back to the shop, to this repair shop, but last night was closed, so I ended up taking it back to the yard. And then this morning, first thing in the morning, we came over here. So yeah, let's go ahead and unhook it. I forgot to turn the PTO on. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and get my light bar out first before I forget. And last night I was not able to put air to the truck. Through the through the air tanks. So I went straight to the air compressor this morning. Last night it had a little bit of air for me to be able to take it back to the yard, so I was fine. But right now you'll see what I did. Thank you. gonna extend it out a little bit before I take anything else out, but this is what I was gonna do. So this is actually my first time doing this through the air compressor. I have never done it. So we basically put some through the air compressor, a quick connect on Freightliners. So yeah, that's the easiest thing to do. I did not know that. But yeah, that was pretty easy. Anyway, so I'm gonna go ahead and extend it out. Start taking the chains out. This one, I might have to bring that the fork a little bit more this way. So I'm gonna drop the truck a little bit. Right there. Ooh, excuse me. And the brakes. Oh, you see that? After I disconnected it, no more air was coming out. And the air pressure still up, which is good. That's a nice trick. I don't know if anybody else knew it, but yeah, this is actually my first time doing it through here. Usually it has a little cap in there. But yeah, air compressor in the back. All right, so now that the brakes are set, I'm gonna go ahead and take my strap from the drive line. Oh man, allergies are killing me. Thank you. out. Just out. Yeah, no problem. You too. So drive line is out,
no
bolts out right there.
Okay.
And the key.
I got it.
Okay,
camera.
Perfect.
Thank you.
All right, yeah, no problem. All right, so now I'm just gonna put everything away. Put this right here. This quick connects, but I've never used them. I usually just go straight to the air tank and that's it. So this is my first time doing it through here, and it worked out perfectly. Again, I'm still trying to figured out this heavy duty thing. Like, you should do medium duties. Medium duties, you really don't have to connect airlines or anything else. So this heavy duty truck, we picked it up last year. When in wait, what am I doing? We picked it up last year in September, and then since then I started working as a heavy duty driver. So yeah, no, I wouldn't say no training, but I kind of knew exactly what to do. But yeah, haven't had any real training with someone that actually knows about heavy duty trucks and all this. So that's the reason why I don't do recoveries on this one, because I know I could do them, but whether or not, I don't wanna look stupid out there. But yeah, if any of you guys know any other trick how to put air, or how to supply air to the trucks. I've seen videos of like people doing it through the air dryer. Another way to the air compressor, I just don't know how. When the air compressor is visible, there's a hose that you disconnect. I don't know which hose it is. I gotta find that out. Air tanks, I know that. And yeah, if there's another way to do it, please put it in the comments. I would love to learn a lot more about this. Again, I'm still new to this. So yeah, all right guys, so this is it. Gonna go ahead and put the remote back, take a couple pictures off the truck that I just dropped, and then head out. Oh, yeah, that lady just scared me. She said, pretty smart, taking pictures. That's the policy with us. We always gotta take pictures. We always take pictures before and after dropping it. All right, guys. Thank you for watching, and I will see you all on the next video.